Welcome, I'm Eleanor Burns. Today we're going to begin a new adventure with Quick Trip Quilts. Now these are three easy strip piece quilts with techniques out of this world. We'll begin with the traditional looking trip with diamonds of color surrounding the center. This one is beautiful in soft pastels of yellow, green, and blue. Next, we'll move into quick quarter quilts, which is similar in technique, but with a cool twist. You can use up all those fat quarters and large scale prints you've been gathering. Now, this one is a garden of colors with flowers cascading in diagonal rows. The third one, a water lily quilt, is very artistic, but still made with those easy strip techniques we just love. The background is strip pieced in water tone fabrics with applique lilies on top. Oh, it's just smashing. So come with me and enjoy the breathtaking journey to our final destination, a spectacular finished quilt. Teresa Barnes and I made a quick trip to her hometown of Totatiche in Jalisco, Mexico, to celebrate her parents' 50th wedding anniversary. When I returned home, I made this queen-size quilt inspired by the bright blue skies, the lush green fields, and the beautiful pink sunsets. What fun we had! Now, my inspiration piece for this quilt was this large-scale, multicolored print with three of the color families in it. I chose 12 colors and all are 2/3 yard cuts. I started with pink rose so it didn't look like a hole right in the center. Then I added two more pinks and different scales of prints and values. Then I progressed into a green that also has pink in it, and then a green that looks solid so it's not so busy looking. Now this is a transition piece. And now we're on a roll with more pink and green. This is another transition fabric that separates the two blues from the others, but yet it unites them as well. Now, one more transition fabric right here, and then the center fabric starts repeating from the center out. Well, I used the same light blue for the first border and the multicolored fabric for the wide outside border. You know, it's amazing how a blend of numerous fabrics just look great together because the pattern is just so organized. And what's even more fun is that you can take the scraps and turn it into this really cute little table runner. It's exactly the same fabrics. The strips are cut at 2.5 inches and then subcut into 1¼ inches. I just love the way these miniature pieces look. Well, today I'm going to show you how to make a crib quilt. Now, there are actually 6 fabrics in it. It starts with that dark blue in the center, followed by 2 more blues. And then from the blue with a yellow, we go into yellow. Ooh, a yellow check. And then a print with yellow in it. A green surrounds the blue. And then that dark blue starts over in the corners. It's very simple with just 2 borders. I made my new granddaughter one exactly the same size. Well, the pieces are all 4-inch pieces. To make this, you need to have 6 1/4 yard pieces. So I've got one piece of fabric already lined up. I tore it from the bolt. I'm going to start off with my 6x24-inch ruler. I have the salvage edge here, the fold here, and I'm just going to line up that torn edge and trim off 1/4 inch. Let's just get that straight looking great. Okay, now that straightens the fabric. The next thing we need are the 4-inch strips. Well, to make my cutting go easier, I put a piece of tape at the 4-inch line on my ruler. Then I don't have to keep on checking every time. Actually, that tape works like a little shelf. You just slip that ruler in there and you cut your strips salvage to salvage. And then once you cut your strips, take and cut on the fold. It's best to work with half strips so you can work with the half strips on the mat easier and also on the cutting mat. Well, I like to use the 6x24, but this ruler is even quicker. So I'm just going to take my fabric and fold the fold down to the salvage edges. And then you just place this ruler with the zero right along the bottom, zeros right along here and along this row. And I put glow line tape right every 4 inches. It's nice bright tape along there. Hold your ruler steady, put your cutter right in that little keyhole, and this time you don't have to move your ruler. You can just zip right along there and cut all of your pieces. And I like having those 4-inch increments marked off. It goes a lot easier. So I've got plenty. To make my crib, I need to have 6 different fabrics. I only need to have 2 salvage to salvage strips for each one cut on the fold. Well, I took my 6 fabrics. This is what I've already planned. There's a nice graduation, just going from one fabric into the next with the pinks, the transition, the green, and then another transition. Well, just so I don't forget, I made a paste-up sheet. And they are numbered in order so that they go from 1 through 6. Well, you think you don't need that, but trust me, once you get sewing, you need to have all of your numbers marked. Well, let me just turn this table around and I'll get ready for sewing. I have my 6 half strips lined up in numbered order. The cut edge is across the top and the salvage edge is across the bottom on all of the strips. Now I want to sew them together into pairs. So I'm starting here with 1 and 2, flipping 2 right sides together to 1, 3 and 4, gotta flip 4 onto 3, and then 5 and 6, 6 goes on to 5. So I can just pedal to the metal now. I'm using a 1/4 inch seam allowance, but this is the best thing. On this quilt, you don't have to have a perfect 1/4 inch. You just need to have a consistent seam allowance. So if you have a little bit of trouble making that perfect quarter, doesn't matter on this quilt. I'm just lining up the 2 outside edges. It's approximately 15 stitches to the inch. So it's just a lot of fun strip sewing, lots of fast sewing. So once you finish one pair, all you have to do is just grab up that second pair and butt it right behind. Just do a lot of chain sewing and get all of these pairs sewn together. Well, when I go on a trip, I love to head off to all of the fabric shops in the area. I mean, I need an excuse to buy fabric. It makes it really fun. So you go into an area on your quick trip and you think about all of the things that are typical of that area and look for fabrics that match the trip. Well, I was just in Tampa, Florida. Oh, they had a great selection of fish fabrics, shell fabrics, ocean, all things that would go together beautifully into one quilt. So that's the fun part of going on a trip. You get to buy more fabric. Well, it's easy to remember because all of the measurements are the same. If you're going to make a lap, you need to have 9 different fabrics and you just buy a half yard of each one of them. For a twin, queen, and king, you only need 12 different fabrics, but they are different measurements. For the twin, it's a half yard. For the queen, it's 2/3. And for the king, it's 3/4. Well, I clip my pairs apart and I have them all set with the even number on top. So now comes some steam. Ooh, I'm a steam person. I'm just gonna line up that straight edge across the line on my pressing mat. And once I set the seam, then you just open and you always press towards the even number. So let's just stack this one. This is 4 on top. I'm just gonna set the seam across the top, open, and press, and I lead with my fingers. I just press open that seam so that it works really great. And then this is the last one. Got 5 and 6. How quick is that? Well, when I made Ellie's quilt, I had so much fun putting it together, and oh my gosh, I love it. I put nice soft fabric on the back and all these beautiful colors. It was just perfect. So let's just lay these back out. We've got all of our cut edges at the top again, and we've got all of the salvages across the bottom. These are the pairs, so now all I have to do is just flip the pairs and sew those together. But I've got one set all ready to go. Already have them pressed towards the even numbers. So this is one, this is six. All I want to do is take and match up these opposite edges. I want to line up those two pieces and now sew it into a tube. Well, that's the fun part. Just get them all lined up, and actually it's just a circle that you want to make. Put the needle down. For a crib size quilt, all I need to make are four different tubes, and it just goes so quickly. Look, I'm nearly already down to the end of this tube. Now this is the seam that I always forget to press, but this seam also gets pressed to the even number. Let's just roll this around. Look at this big old tube here. So look at the way the seams are already pressed, the way they're going, and just lay your tube flat and just push your seams right over. Now, we've got this tube. This is going to be the amazing part. Just place it on your cutting mat, and I like to roll it so that number one is on the top. And this tool is going to do the cutting so quickly. Now we need to cut into 2.5-inch segments. So let's just line up the line right along here. Perfect. Grab your cutting mat. What's unique about this one is that the marks are only every 2.5 inches. So you can just zip right across there. Put your cutter in the keyhole. Out of one tube, you should get a total of 8 of these. Let's just check and see how fast was that. Take this, get rid of it. 1, 2, 3, perfect. 2.5-inch pieces and a little bit to spare. Well, let me finish sewing all of these pieces together and I'll show you how to cut up these tubes. You need a total of 30 tubes. There are even 2 extras that you can mess up on. How lucky is that? Well, I divided them into 2 stacks of 15. This is for the top half. I'm going to set that aside. And this is for the bottom half. And now comes the fun part. I'm going to just cut these tubes apart in order. Okay, this is my first tube, and this is number one. Remember number one. So I'm just going to start with my scissors and just cut on those stitches. Just get rid of that little thing. Open it up and place this piece in the very middle. That's the beginning. You need a big table. This is big. Thank heavens. Okay, now I'm going to take 2 more tubes, and I'm going to take number one and fold it in half. Okay, just line up those seams, get that all lined up, cut right through the middle of number one, and just repeat that with the same piece. With the second piece, exactly the same. Line up those seams and cut right through in the middle. Now, one goes on the left side, and one goes on the right side. Oh my gosh, we got a pattern going. Okay, so now we've done with one. We did a whole and we did a half of one. So now let's go between one and two. There's that seam there. Let's take 2 of them, roll both of them, so 2 is at the top. Grab your scissors, cut on the seam straight as you can, and if you want, you can even just use your rotary cutter and your ruler. Cut across there, take these, get rid of them. Okay, open up, so 2 is at the top. Place 1 on the left and 1 on the right. Ooh, it's already looking good. So 2 more and roll them, so number 2 is at the top. Just keep on rolling. Now I already have a whole number 2, so I need to have a half of number 2. So just roll it along like this and line up that seam, and you can already see how that pattern is coming along. Let me roll these. I like to really match that seam. And what's really great about this is that whenever you place these pieces, then the seams all go down. They all line up going down. Okay, let's take this one, put it right on there. Now, that's the beginning, and I'm gonna just keep on cutting until I have all 15 in a row. And then I'm gonna start on one side and start sewing down and just keep on adding these one after the other. Now you can see the best part is that there's nothing to match. Oh, we should cheer about that. There's nothing to match all along there, except you would like to match the top and the bottom. Well, let me get sewing. I'm gonna make both halves. I have both halves done. They are identical. Now, I hope you didn't need those two extra tubes when you were cutting these apart and putting them back together. Well, now they're done. Next thing is to press them. You place them on your pressing mat, wrong side up, and you start on the left side with your iron, and you just press straight across, always pressing over to the left. You press both of them exactly the same, because in the next step, it's magical. You take your two halves, and now they just go together like this in the middle. And when you flip them right sides together, every seam locks. That's what's the best part, because this could be pretty tricky if those seams didn't line up just so. Well, just get sewing on it. It is the same quarter of an inch or whatever seam that you've been using. Just start on the outside edge. Now, if you need to straighten up this edge, go ahead and do that just with a little bit of sliver trimming. But I'm just going to anchor them together and then lock that first seam and then just continuously sew the straight across. It's amazing when they lock how well they go together. Well, I think my favorite quick trip is to Alaska. Oh my goodness, the wonderful fabrics that you can get. The fabrics all look like the woods, the animals, the bears. They're just great. Oh, moose, I can't get enough of moose fabric. But it's really fun to just pick those fabrics up that you get on your trip, put them all together into one really cute quick trip. Well, I'm just doing a little stretching along here. It's going along great. If you need to also straighten up the opposite end, it's perfect. Just a little bit more, and you're going to see how great this looks in the middle. Line them up, squeeze them together. Stiletto will help. And once you get these two halves all put together, then just press that middle seam open. Let's see. Got that whole center sewn together. Wonderful how it looks. Take a look at that. It's perfect. Well, my borders are all cut and ready to go on there. I'm going to frame it in this light fabric first and then use that multicolored floral around the outside edge. Now, how quick is this? I already have one completely finished. And on this one, it's great to just do a stitch in the ditch all around there. Or if you like me and you like to send it out to a long arm quilter, an overall pattern is perfect to get this quilt completed. Well, I'm going to make a quick trip off to Alaska to get some more moose fabric. Enjoy. Hop aboard and take a trip around the world with me. Let's gallop over to Montana for this queen size quilt. It's such a fun quilt with brown horses, red and navy cowboys, and covered wagons in bright yellow. Well, the yellow is a transition fabric and breaks up the rounds. The fabrics aren't in color families, yet they all look wonderful together. I like this quilt for that very reason. You know, Linda Parker says even ugly fabrics look good in this quilt. She might be right. It's great. Well, we'll hop on over to Grandma's house with Depression Era prints. Now, doesn't this just remind you of a quilt Grandma had with small prints and polka dots. Teresa grouped prints together with similar colors. Well, the second yellow is a transition piece to break up the rounds and give your eyes a resting place. And the red makes a bold statement. Love this one too. Well, we can skip over to Phoenix. This quilt definitely makes me think hot. Linda Parker made this quilt remembering the day she visited her daughter, Christy. The mercury hit an all-time high of 115 degrees that day. There are five reds that progress into five oranges and end with two bold yellows. Ooh, and that black framing border holds it all in. Jenna Mitchell quilted large suns out of variegated thread. Absolutely magnificent. Well, if we're talking hot, why not make a quick trip across the ocean to Hawaii? Well, we could do the hula on this quilt. The fabric has palm leaves, huge orchids, muumuus, and volcanoes. Yellow is in the center, and it progresses into red, yellow, and green. And then the prints start all over again. And the lime green on the back is perfect. Well, we're up the hill in East San Diego for my quick trip to Julian. This is one of my favorite quilts. Actually, I made this quilt. I love the country colors that match my home, the bear's paw. When I made it, I mixed cotton and flannel. Worked great together. I could snuggle in this quilt any day. And then the matching one is made from the leftovers, just as beautiful, very soft. Fantastic. Well, Sue Bouchard named this quilt My Trip to Provence while strolling through the French countryside and enjoying the colors and sights of the region. She purchased the French fabric to mimic those colors. The bright, clear fabrics in this quilt keep the memories alive. That's good. Keep the memories alive. Well, the last trip we'll take today is one to honor the troops. It's called United We Stand. This quilt is a tribute to all who serve in our armed forces. It starts in the center with blue and progresses into white and ends with stripes of blue, white, and red. The flag fabric is very patriotic. So why not plan your next quick trip to San Diego and stop by Quilt in a Day, where you are always welcome to visit and share the warmth and friendship of quilts. The one thing is always certain, mi casa es su casa.